Hello YouTube, this is Dragonheart, the Prince of Wales, and welcome back to the Wales campaign. So, we're doing very well in this campaign, and first of all, I'd like to thank you all very much for your support. Plenty of you guys have commented on the past videos in this Let's Play. People like Watcher of the Leech, people like Mr. Rocket. You know, you've been fantastic, and you've really been encouraging throughout this campaign. And hopefully I've been able to make a campaign that, you know, you guys can be proud of and enjoy. And also perhaps help you out with some of the tips and some of the things I've done in this campaign. But anyway, let's continue. So Canterbury, we have some units here which I think could probably hold out against Captain Edgar, which is good. This General Anselm of Bampton needs to be taken out though. Once he's gone, I should be okay in this campaign. I will be sallying out at some point with King Llewellyn. And in the previous episode, right at the end, we took Lincoln as well. We might have to hold out against this captain. They do seem to have quite a lot of cavalry. We do have quite a lot in our treasury as well, so it's important that I continue to recruit units along the way. So perhaps Oxford can recruit some units now, because this is quite near where the English settlements are. So we are retraining a couple. We've got spear militia on the way. So perhaps, let's get two more English billmen there at Oxford. I don't know if I can actually get anything in Lincoln. I can't. I can retrain though. Although I can't afford it at the moment. Chester is also getting some troops as well. Shrewsbury can get another unit of English billmen. And Lancaster can actually get lots of things in Lancaster. We're going to get some Gwent Raiders and some Merinoid Spearmen. And that would probably be enough to take Newcastle upon Tyne as well. Same with Carlisle. We want to try and get as much as we can. Although I can't get anything in Carlisle at the moment. Although I can retrain the English billmen, which I will be doing. There are things I can construct and improve upon with the money, which I'm going to start doing now. So I think Carnarvon is due some work. So we're going to look and get some communal farming here. We're going to get... let's have a look. Paved roads, maybe a leather tanner eventually. Yeah, we may go for that now actually. Ballista maker, oh, that will do for now. We're going to big upgrade on Carnarvon. Basically I'm doing this because this is the center of my empire. If you look at the whole map of Britain, Carnarvon is more or less dead in the center of everything. When I eventually invade Ireland, I'm going to be recruiting good units from Carnarvon and sailing straight across to there. It's also going to be going north to Norway and to Scotland, so we need to use Carnarvon as a big kind of settlement for us, a big fortress, a big recruitment hub, if you will. I'm also going to get a unit of Merinoid Spearmen, and I'm going to actually get two units of Marathral Horsemen, because I haven't actually recruited them yet in this campaign. I'm just going to double check things now to see that I'm on the right path with everything. I think I am. This General Mired the... Oh, I haven't moved him yet. Right, so I could get some mercenaries, which... Why not? We're going to get some mercenary crossbowmen. We're going to go this way towards Oxford. We're going to pass through Oxford towards London. And we need to kind of hold on to Canterbury as well eventually. So we can actually recruit in Canterbury. So we might want to get some... Don't want spear militia. We want heavy English billmen. And a ballista. And that should be enough at Canterbury to hold out against Captain Edgar. Once those units are recruited, we'll attack them ourselves. But for now, we're just going to be on the defensive there. Norwich needs to be taken as well. Okay, so we're going to end turn. I think that's probably enough. Although I haven't used my spy yet, so let's move the spy first. Scottish merchant there. Where's my merchant to? Down there. Nope, he's not. Where is he? Don't think I have a merchant anymore. Oh my, I thought I had a merchant. Anyway, let's click the end turn button for turn 22, and we are being attacked at Lincoln, which I kind of anticipated. And I should say as well, I'm using a different recording software for this episode, so let me know what the video quality is like. I'm actually using an NVIDIA Shadowplay, which I haven't used yet. But I've watched a couple of tutorials online. I've gone with the configuration, which I think should be useful. And we have a bride presented. Betrothed, how will Gronwy is Magred Ruhalon, which we'll accept. Riot in Oxford. We're going to have to be careful in Oxford because we will lose it if we dilly-dally too much. Mission failed. Oh, I forgot about this. Doesn't matter. Construction report. Oxford got a church. London got a blister tower. Marriage. Excellent. Recruitment report. Lots of new units now. End of turn report. We are doing well. And a settlement besiege at Lincoln. So, I think what we will be doing is we will be giving this unit of cavalry to Mairdi. And he can actually give the ballista to Oxford. And there aren't many troops in Oxford, actually, are there? We are building some more, though. Marathi is going to continue marching forward. He's actually going to go... We could help out the north in Lincoln. I think, personally, it's better than he goes to Norwich. I don't know where Anselm of Bampton has gone, either. Now, we've actually come across an English army here, so we're going to actually attack them. And we're going to have a battle, so Treherne of Brycheiniog versus Captain Samuel. So we only have 3 units of Welsh spearmen, but we are going to fight. They are mercenary Welsh spearmen, so I don't mind actually losing them, because they're just going to have a big upkeep cost. Basically, once I use the mercenaries for a few turns, once I'm happy, I will be disbanding them. Okay, so start deployment time. We're just going to start deployment straight away. The English, of course, are up there. We're going to keep the spearmen at the front, at the ready, with the cavalry behind. And let's have a quick look over here to see what the English are doing. Looks like they are coming towards us. They have 3 units themselves. They have bow units. They have, what are these? Spearmen, by the looks of things. Oh, actually. Yes, they are spearmen, I think. And then we have more spearmen. So, not really anything to be too concerned about. I'm just going to bring all the units forward and bring the cavalry forward. So I'm going to fast forward this battle as well, because it's just going to be a straightforward, quick battle. I don't want to waste too much time. Let's get the units into position. Balance of power is slightly in our favour. There we go, lovely. Go to normal speed, and there we go. We'll take over now. So let's get these men up. We are starting to take some fire. We're going to move the general to the right flank, if possible. There we go, lovely. I'm actually going to try and move these spear units in a way that will divide them all up. Yeoman archers are going to cause me trouble, so let's get the general up quicker. Let's fast forward again. We've taken a few losses, which I don't like. And now it would be a good time to probably charge. So let's charge with them. Let's run up the right flank. And the cavalry is going to go for a charge on the Yeoman archers. They are too near the armoured sergeants for my liking. I don't like this so far. Oh, this is good. They've stopped. Even better for me. I can get a charge away on the armoured sergeants. This is good. We've taken out half of the Yeoman archers already. We haven't lost the unit. Now we're going to pull out quickly with the general. Get him out of there quickly. They've held up the units long enough for my spearmen to get into a decent position now. We've taken out lots and lots of archers, and now spearmen can just charge straight towards the English. We're going to actually take on the armoured sergeants, all 3 of these. And the Yeoman archers are actually gone right to the back. So my cavalry is going to go to the back as well, while the spearmen can all attack the armoured sergeants. This is going very well at the moment, this little skirmish. And we now got around the billmen, so we can go for a charge on the archers. A nice clean charge on them. We could chase them off the battlefield and wipe them all out, while my mercenary Welsh spearmen can hold up the rest of the English. This is fantastic so far. Let's get a rallying cry going. We've actually routed the Yeoman archers. Pardon me. So we're going to keep chasing them down while we hold the rest of the English up. Defeat's almost a certainty. I think it is a certainty. Going to let this general kill as many archers as he can. Although, saying that, I probably want to be charging the billmen from behind. I want to take them all out, though. I want to kill them all. And the billmen seem to have regrouped. Don't mind that. The spearmen can take on the rest of them. This is good so far. Pulling the cavalry away now. And pull them right back. One horse seems to have got lost. It's okay, we haven't lost him. We still have all our horses. We're going to sit back, let the Welsh spearmen absorb the pressure. There's 34 and 25 remaining. And we are winded, but that's fine. Give it a few seconds and then we will go for a charge. As a matter of fact, we're going to go for a charge on the heavy billmen as they've come out of the group. 21 horses against 25 heavy billmen. There we go. Get a good charge. Oh, look at that. Lovely charge. Good tidings. The enemy general, behold how our cowardly foe runs. And the general has run. Look at that. That one charge has won the battle for us. Captain Samuel died in that charge. We took them all out in one charge. We can charge the rest of them. Spearman did well. I'm going to fast forward this now. There we go, lovely. Just get them all dead. Men remaining none. Excellent battle. Very straightforward. Pretty easy. Didn't have to think about it too much. And I can ransom. That's been rejected. So that army's gone off the map now. And this army can continue to march forward now towards this captain here, Captain Morcar. Which is what we're going to do. We're going to actually move slowly. As you can see, Nottingham is right there, so we need to be careful. And Nottingham is the one settlement I haven't taken yet, and it's been one of the difficult settlements for me. I can get some Sherwood archers, though, which I'm going to actually get. This is going to be a mercenary army, which is going to attack Captain Morcar. And we have another battle on our hands, and we'll fight this battle as well. So any English army, whether they're a big army like Anselm of Bampton, or a small army like Captain Morcar, the aim is to try and wipe them off the map. The less armies running around the campaign map, the easier it is for my armies to envelop them and eventually take them out. I'm just going to wait. Wait again and see if we can get a good map. And that'll do. Don't think it's going to make too much difference, but it's worth trying to get a decent battle kind of scenario if possible. They have mercenary crossbowmen, which we have to be wary of. But we do heavily outnumber the English this time. My general's going to actually go up to that right flank because it's a nice area to charge down. Always use the hills. Nice hill here. Cavalry, full speed, charge down. They will break enemies. They have swordsmen, which is good. Crossbowmen, which is good to charge. Mercenary crossbowmen. I can actually charge all of these. There's no spearmen there, so my cavalry can be as free as they like and charge them all. I'm actually firing upon the mercenary crossbowmen with the mercenary Sherwood archers. Not using fire because the fire isn't as accurate as the normal bows, although it does do more damage. So we are hoping to get more kills, and we've got a few already. I'm just looking to see what I can charge with this general. I'm just going to get him into a position. I'm going to run him up this hill now, actually. Only 18 crossbowmen remaining. In this battle, I'm actually just going to go for the charge. I'm going to tell the infantry to charge. There we go. It's just going to issue attack orders. As you can see, they've gone now. Those mercenary crossbowmen. I am going to worry about these. We've caught some swordsmen in the charge, which is brilliant, and we've taken out... We're going to take out some of the crossbowmen as well. We've actually taken out all the swordsmen, I think, in that one charge. Another mercenary crossbowman will fall as well. Fast forward till we get the win. There we go, lovely. Cavalry doing a fantastic job. Continue the battle. There we go, we killed their general. That's what I wanted. Another kill. Another win. I'll get my general to charge down there now and hopefully get the kill on the mercenary crossbowmen. Let's just follow this battle till the end now. Want to wipe them all out. Kill all Englishmen. 5 remaining. Can we get them before they escape? I think we can. I think we have. Oh. One left. Got him. There we go. Lovely. Lost one man whole all battle. Fantastic win. Which makes it easier on the campaign map, like I said. So Nottingham, of course, we can't attack and ransom these, which has been accepted. A bit more money for us. Victory! Red to do expands. He's a sword bearer now, so we've got some more stats going, which is fantastic. Nottingham. Oh, it's going to be difficult to take Nottingham, I think, isn't it? Which is why I need to get Myrthi up there. Maybe Myrthi should go for Nottingham. Although he doesn't have siege equipment, so it's going to be awkward. Although I think Shrewsbury can recruit siege equipment. Oh, no, we can't. It's actually Montgomery I need for this. We're actually going to get 3 catapults at Montgomery, and they're all going to go towards Lincoln. Well, towards Nottingham, and they're going to be used to take out the remaining English forces. Now, the army, the rebel army that was outside Canterbury has gone towards London. Something to consider, maybe. Just check everything. Cardiff, Montgomery, Carnarvon. Recruiting lots of things in Carnarvon. Lots of buildings being recruited anyway. Just checking all my settlements briefly. Right, I think we need to think about heading towards Newcastle now. Let's head north. And York is there for the taking as well. Actually, Traherne of Brycheiniog can go towards York. He probably has enough to take it, looking at this. Oh yes, I think we can take York. Defend. Although he could probably be used to defend Lincoln, which of course will probably be lost. So we need to think about this now. Norwich is just waiting there. I could sally out of Canterbury, I think. Let's just click on everything. They'd be a little bit pissed off if I do leave. Let's leave behind some Rhelwyr axemen and some spear militia for now. And let's recruit some weak units. And Howell Gronwy can actually attack these peasants. Auto-resolve this one. An average victory, unfortunately. But it's a victory nonetheless. Which I'm happy about. And I'm actually going to be waiting on this bridge here so that Captain Edgar can't come back to Canterbury. A trait increase, he feels happy, and a trait increase, plus 3 command. So now Captain Gronwy is going to wait on the bridge. So if Captain Edgar does decide to attack me with his units, we can wait on the bridge and make a good defense. We have some, well, we don't have much infantry, unfortunately, so we've got to make use of all our missile troops and basically skirmish as much as we can. But if we do lose, we can fall back to Canterbury. And of course, London can actually assist us as well. King Llewellyn, which I'm probably going to have to be using now. Again, he's been waiting in this campaign for a long time. We're going to recruit some heavy bill Englishmen. We're going to actually keep retraining some of these units here. Just spend lots of money retraining these. We'll have a good strong infantry army from Llewellyn then to push on out. So I think that primarily does the campaign aspect of this. Let's just double check. Probably get some Welsh militiamen here, which I'm going to do. Because Newcastle's there for the take-in as well, which we haven't actually done anything about yet. I'm actually going to be pushing out of Lancaster with these 5 units. I'm going to push north. I could have actually used them to go to York. But I'm going to take them along with Prince David from Carlisle. With Scythier Bowman, Mercenary Crossbowman, and some English Heavy Billmen. That's enough to take Newcastle. So we're going to go to Newcastle while we have units at Carlisle. The reason why I'm keeping units in these settlements is so they don't revolt straight away. And in case if Scotland does decide to declare war, we'll have something there at least to defend it. Okay, so plan. Prince David goes to Newcastle. Traherne of Brycheiniog assists at Lincoln to help defend it. Prince David can eventually descend upon York. Myrthi is going to go towards Nottingham. And the king won't be far behind him. And hopefully I can take out Captain Edgar as well. So we've got plenty of things in place. So again, I'm going to click end turn. Plenty of money was spent that turn. It looks like Lincoln, Captain Philip, has decided to attack me at Lincoln. So Vortimer Howell, who's been a kind of unsung hero of this campaign, is going to be defending in this battle. So let's fight the battle. It's a 7-5 in their favour. We have lots of bowmen though, so we need to use them as best as we can. There we go. My lord, if we cross the bridge, we are dead men. Traitorous Scottish knight Richard Lundy at the Battle of Stirling Bridge. So here we go. The English are in a big massive blob. Unfortunately, we have no walls, which I don't like. We have towers that can be used. And we have lots of bowmen. So what we're going to do is get all bow units grouped up. And they're going to be... Oh my god, we're going to put them into a good formation. Nice line. Loose formation. I think something like that would be preferential. And then English billmen at the front of the gate. Like so. With Gwent raiders. And then cavalry units are going to be grouped. Do we have a second gate nearby that I can utilize? There's one up here. That's probably too far away. This one's better. Cavalry can be grouped into a nice formation like so. That's close enough. I'm going to start the battle. I'm doing that so I can flank around if I need to hit them. Well, if I need to flank them and hit them in the bum, basically. We're actually going to not be using our fire arrows. We want the accuracy in this battle. And it looks like they're only using the one ram, so what we're going to be doing, once all my missiles are in range, they're going to actually be aiming for the armoured swordsman. This is great, we've got some fire, or some shots raining in upon them straight away. I think we've killed a few of them, which is always nice to see. There we go, lovely. Get them all to aim for the one target. It's going to be a difficult battle, this is, because I have barely any infantry. So the aim is to kind of kill as many armoured swordsmen as I can to stop them coming out. Which I think we're doing a pretty good job of so far. Plenty of arrows flying all over the place. My skirmishers will be able to start doing it soon as well. Look at all those arrows flying down, oh my. We've killed 7% with just my arrows, which is good. I do wish I had some infantry, it would have made things a lot easier. Lots and lots of longbowmen and mailed knights. If I had spearmen, it would be something. I'm actually going to charge out now with the English billmen to hopefully disrupt them and stop them charging this gate. I'm going to take my general at the settlement as well. There we go. This is going to be awkward. This works in my favour, get back in the settlement. The gate will slam shut on them. Well, the gate should have slammed shut on them, but it didn't. The walls are no longer ours. The enemy have taken them. Oh my goodness. I was hoping it would disrupt them and stop them coming in, but actually it's not the case. They've actually come in now. They are going to start killing loads of my men. Damn it. Cavalry gonna charge the heavy infantry. If I had a second kind of army nearby, I think this would be a good position for us. But they've actually, look at the big blob, it just blobbed straight in. I'm gonna lose Lincoln, unfortunately. But we have inflicted some damage upon the enemy, which is good. Pardon me. Let's get out there quickly and go for a second charge with the general. Water Powell still may survive this somehow. We've actually pulled some of these infantrymen out. The longbowmen are coming out as well. If we can take out the longbowmen, that's something less to worry about in the future battle, so it might be worth doing that, although the mailed knights are charging towards now. Heavy cavalry. Oh, we're going to get caught up. Water Powell can't withdraw either, so he's on his own in this battle. And we've been chased out of our own settlement, oh my god. Turn around and fight, you fools. Disable skirmish and fire upon the feudal knights. And Vortipa Howell is kind of on his own. He's trapped. Surrounded by Englishmen everywhere. Gonna try and get him out of there at least. Not many men left. And at least we are getting kills on the horses here. On the cavalry. The aim is just to weaken them as much as we can now for a future battle. We know we got the superiority on the campaign map. And we're able to bring units to the battle. So just weaken them as much as we can, which we can see we're doing. Let's go back to Vortipa Howell now. Who actually has mailed knights attacking him behind, so he's going to have to fight them off. Go back to this part of the battlefield, and we're getting chased now by more longbowmen. Oh, pardon me. Let's get out of the settlement. We've got a minute left anyway, so let's make the most of it. Vortipa Howell's going to die, I think. Let's go back and see. I think he's still alive. Intervention by the Almighty, or a military genius can bring us victory from this. Oh, he's still fighting. 5 against 3. Good tidings. The enemy general is dead. Oh, we killed a general. What a way to end. We've actually killed a general. Vortipa Howell done very well. But we've lost. Killed a general and lost. But he's still alive, Vortipa Howell, so that's something at least. We lost 200 men. But we killed over 100 of theirs. To weaken them even further. We've lost Lincoln again. So Lincoln, we've won and lost twice now. I think Vortipa Howell's probably dead as well. So even though he didn't die in the battle, he still somehow dies, which is a bit unfortunate. But
the fires of independence burn brightly in Scotland. Weary of aggression from its neighbours, a new hero has emerged to unite Scotland's clans. His name is William Wallace. A minor noble he may be, but behind him march thousands of warriors, each one with freedom in his heart and a sword in his hand.
Well, William Wallace has arrived. Oh my goodness. A candidate for adoption, Ivor of Merionaeth. We're going to say yes. Time machine's been made. New mission. It's time we apply pressure upon our foe, sending a fleet to blockade this port for at least 3 turns. We're not only... Okay, so we've got to blockade Dublin, which I'm actually going to try and do, so let's get our ships. We've got a few of them here. Dublin's up here, of course. We can attack that dock. A noble death. Vortipa Howell is dead, of course. Recruitment report. Recruited lots of things now. End of turn. And then the settlement has been occupied. So what we're going to do now is take the three siege engines towards Nottingham. Pardon me, got a bad cough. Anselm of Bampton has actually targeted Trien of Brycheiniog, which is great. We could sit in the fort. And Mairdhi can edge towards Nottingham without actually going there. Canterbury's fine now. My spy is going to backtrack slightly to see where the English are. Not around here at least. They must have regrouped with Anselm or Nottingham, I'm assuming. Right, Prince David can actually get the Newcastle this turn. Although there's a rebel army in the way, which we're going to ignore. Scots Pike Militia, but we can actually go to Newcastle upon Tyne. We can't quite get there this turn, but we can take them. This spear militia, our bows would wipe them out easily. So we're going to go for that with Prince David, and that should be taken within the next turn or two. Move my spy down here to get a better view. So yeah, not much has changed really. We're still aiming for the same few settlements. We are going to try and convert to a wooden castle though to help us out. We're going to recruit another unit up here just to help Carlisle's public order. Oxford's actually happy now, so we've done well there. My ballistas towards Nottingham, my thieves towards Nottingham, and eventually the king will be coming as well with his own ballista, but he's retraining a few units first. It's important that I retrain these so I got the best army that I can possibly muster. Just double checking a few things. I need to think about taking Norwich, and I think Howell of Goronwy is probably the best man to do it. So he's going to go towards Norwich. Howell of Goronwy can take Norwich out for me. They have nothing there basically, so it should be okay. And then the might of London. So this is what's boiled down to. It's going to be the might of the English army around here, the main army there, and the main army of Wales here. It's going to be a big battle, and once that battle's over, if we win, which hopefully we can, then we will be pretty much conquering England, apart from Dublin, which of course I'm planning to do once I've recruited some more stuff at Caernarfon. I can actually get some ships here ready, so we may just do that, get one ship there ready for us. And what do we have in Caernarfon? We don't have much there, so we can start thinking about getting some Scythier bowmen just to keep things ticking over. And I think we can possibly end the turn once more. Just gonna make sure I'm doing things right now, which I appear to be. Ivor Medinoid is at Canterbury, so he can stay there, I think. Lincoln, I want to take Lincoln again. That was annoying, losing Lincoln. Let's end turn. And I anticipated this, which has actually gone in my favour, so I'll tell you about that in a second. So candidate for adoption, benefactor Howell Goronwy. We'll take you. Another general actually in London, Philip Einion. Construction complete, recruitment report, and an end of turn report. So what we're going to be doing now, we're going to be pushing out with the king, I think. So, although saying that, we're still waiting to retrain, I think, aren't we? Oh, actually, no, we're not. Okay, so what we're going to do, let's just make sure I don't make a mistake or misclick anything here. So first of all, Howell Goronwy is going to go towards Norwich. He can get mercenaries, he doesn't need them, though. So we're going to leave that like that. Prince David attacks Newcastle upon Tyne, builds a few siege equipment. That's great. Okay. Carlisle's been upgraded, so we've now got the good public order, which is excellent. We are being besieged by Anselm of Bampton, which is what I wanted, believe it or not, because I can come up behind him with this army, which I'm going to be doing. But before that, Llewellyn must leave London. And he is going to take with him 1, 2, 3, 4 units of English billmen. He's going to be taking 2 units of heavy English billmen. He's going to take with him 3 units of Merinoid spearmen. He's going to take with him 3 units of Gwent raiders. He's going to be taking with him 1 unit of Hellweird bowmen. And that's all he can take at the moment. We want 1 ballista unit as well to join up with him. And I'm looking to see, the ballista can probably go to him as well. and join up to get the ballista. Just looking to see what can be used. Cavalry can come to him. Want cavalry. It's going to take a few turns to get all of these stuff here. Cavalry can go to him from Oxford. Makes his army a lot stronger, doesn't it? Excellent. Now, decision time. Mairdhi is going to come up behind Anselm of Bampton. And we can actually auto-resolve this. We're not going to, though. We're actually going to fight this. So, allow something to be controlled by the AI. Do I want the AI in charge of Mairdhi? Of Trachan of Bahainiog? Yes, I'm going to control the larger army. I'm going to let the AI decide what to do with him. I think I can do a lot of damage with just the one army. So I'm going to fight this battle. And then after this battle, I'm going to end this episode. It's been an extra long episode. It'll probably be about an hour or so in length, which I'm happy with because I haven't done an hour on this campaign yet. I think the longest episode was about 45 minutes. So plenty of campaign action and battles. And look at that lovely bridge. That is exactly what we want. Hopefully my reinforcements are going to come behind me. I don't even mind if they come behind the English. So naturally we're going to take the spearmen. We're going to group them up. We're going to put them into a formation. We're going to get all the bow units grouped. Loose formation. This is too good to be true. Right, what we're going to do is actually put... Oh, I thought I could deploy stakes. Ah, only in certain scenarios. That's a shame, because I wanted to deploy the stakes where I was standing. Let me just work this out a sec. How far I have to go to get the damn stakes. Has to be here, unfortunately. Although that works quite well. Catches a little bit of the pathway. That could be better. About there. So we're catching a little bit of the pathway. Then the spearmen are going to be at the front. Like as you'd expect, with the cavalry grouped up into a formation at the rear. Mercenary crossbowmen grouped up and ready. Start the battle. Archers are going to be put into a loose formation. Mercenary crossbowmen are going to be brought forward. And what's coming towards me? Peasant archers are actually charging towards me, I think. No, they're not. Am I... allies actually deployed behind them, so we've got a chance to envelop them here. Now I'm going to actually take this opportunity to go towards the English. Actually no, we're going to halt. We can outrange them from here. No point chasing them across that bridge yet. Peasant archers won't know what hit them. Maybe we can entice some of them to come across the bridge. That's what I'm aiming for. Of course they have ballista I need to be careful of. I do wish I'd controlled the other army now. Didn't realise it was going to be on a bridge. I got a good defensive position here as well. My sighted bowmen have gone across the bridge. Just a little bit. I think we want to aim towards the heavy bill militia, I think. Although we are taking out lots of the peasant archers, so this is good so far. But we're going to have to be careful of that, because that's going to cause damage, so... oh, pardon me, let's actually aim for the catapult with this unit. And if they do decide to charge across with the cavalry, we of course got a good defensive position just the other side of that bridge. Meanwhile, the rest of my force are idle. And we have cavalry, we have spearwood, Welsh spearmen and Sherwood archers, so we have a decent army that side as well.
For the moment, the fortune of battle goes our way. Let's pray it remains as such.
Reform the spearmen. I'm going to tell my ally to go for a shootout stance. He can then use his archers to attack the English. Now we are losing Thythia to bowmen, so this is awful for us really. We're on a weak kind of position here. As you can see, but they are wasting their ammunition on us at the moment, which I'm happy about. And if we can shoot them from behind, they'll be outflanked and won't know what to do. Oh, I can't afford to keep this going like this. My reinforcements. What are they doing? They haven't actually moved. I'm going to have to tell them to go for an aggressive stance, I think. Let them be aggressive. They're now firing upon us. Sitting ducks in this position really. Oh my goodness. They're using fire as well. They are going to get some kills on me. Has my AI reinforcements arrived yet? What are they doing? Don't like this. Come on dudes, attack. I'm gonna tell the AI, try and attack if possible. Yes, I do wish I'd controlled them now. I was hoping to get them to charge me on the bridge. Let's use the crossbowmen. Oh my. Peasant archers doing damage. The mercenary crossbowmen can attack the Sherwood archers. I don't know what my ally is doing at the moment. They just seem to be sitting down, unfortunately. Come on. Attack. Where do they keep going? Attack, come on. I need you to attack. This is the perfect battle strategy. We got them on a bridge. Use this advantage, come on. I don't want to send my infantry across this bridge. I'm gonna have to, I think. Oh, I wanted to kill Anselm of Bampton in this battle. Guy keeps eluding me all the time. I'm gonna fast forward this a little bit more. And yes, it appears my AI ally isn't gonna be doing anything. Unfortunately. Holy crap, they could outflank him by now. This one guy just standing there firing. I can show you. Oops. Excellent. Excellent, excellent. Get back quickly, you fool. Perfect. Pull cavalry back. Exactly what I wanted. More or less. I think they've killed some of their own horses there. Spearman onto the general's bodyguard. You actually charge the general's bodyguard with the spearman now. Yes! It was worth it to get him dead. Anselm of Bampton is no more. Plan worked. Eventually. Didn't think they'd ever charge me, but it worked.
The battle is very much in our favor. If we remain true and steadfast, victory will be ours.
Doing a good job. Let's get that spearman up across the bridge now. They're only sure what archers charge them. Maybe we can chain route them if we keep going. We are going to need to bring the cavalry across soon as well. Bow units out of ammunition so they can charge in. We're only fighting crossbowmen and archer militia. This should be okay. All the infantry still at the back. And my men are actually making it towards the battlefield now as well. And we've actually caught them. This is perfect. We can smash through, hopefully. I'm going to actually send the male knights across, and the general's bodyguard can go across without actually impaling themselves on the spears. We're going to take the bridge though. It's Sherwood archers and archer militia. We can take these out. I'm actually going to charge the generals across now. They're not going to get caught up on the spikes, which is good. Excellent. We can just push across now. Look at that. We've taken the bridge. We've taken the whole bridge. Anselm of Bampton is no more. We can rout the English off. Look at that sight. Chasing them all down. We've had unit routes. We don't care. We've actually won this battle, I think. They have lost half their men. Let's chase the catapults now. We're going to have to reform with the rest of my army, which is actually using this Sherwood archers to pick off some of the English. I'm actually going to be using the cavalry to take out the catapult. While my infantry can engage the town militia. Excellent. We routed them as well. Look at this chain route. They're routing all over the place. They don't know where to go. Chase them down with the cavalry. We've chased the archer militia towards my own men. Charge the town militia. Bang! Just routed the heavy bill militia with one charge. Let's break through them. Get the general to go through. We've got mailed knights following up. Oh, they're all gone. Look at that. Continue the slaughter. This is the biggest English army, apart from the army at Nottingham. They're in disarray. Let's wipe them out. Let's kill them all. Fast forward this, of course. Look at the English running away. Chase them all. I think they've escaped. I think I'll do, so let's exit the battle there.
This is a clear victory that goes to only men of great virtue and valor.
Absolutely slammed them with that bridge battle. I didn't think it was going to work. I didn't think the AI was eventually attack. And I could ransom these men, but I'm going to actually execute them. We don't want them coming back. And Anselm of Bampton is no more. We finally wiped him out. And now Myrddi is going to join up with the remnants of the army there. It's a bigger, to make a much bigger army, which could probably take on Nottingham, looking at that now. That's exactly what we're going to be doing. We've got lots and lots of bows. And plus, Llewellyn's going to be outflanking them now. He's going to be coming from the south. We can squeeze Nottingham and take it. Howell Gronwy is going to go and take Norwich. That's where Captain Arthur went. He's going towards York, which eventually will be taken by Prince David, who's actually attacking Newcastle upon Tyne. And I think we're going to be ending the episode right there. So fantastic episode yet again. Also, thank you for your support. It's been fantastic. I've been Dragonheart, the Prince of Wales. Thank you for watching. Until next time, goodbye.